Hi students, this is Professor Vick, and this video is to show you how to use Google Scholar. Alright, I'll use, for example, what we're supposed to do on Lab 2. I have the Weird Economics Home site up here, so I'll scroll down to Lab 2, Lab 2 Comparing Outcomes. And we got Lab 2 here. Okay, so you know, we're supposed to do a bit of research here on some information. We want to write a paragraph about how daycare or childcare affects female labor force participation. Okay, so I mentioned you can use Google Scholar, IUP iSearch to do that. All right, and I give you a few hints of what to search for. All right, so I'm just going to highlight this. I'll actually change it up a bit, but I'm going to copy this, okay, daycare female labor force participation, and then I go over here to my other browser window. I'm going to type in scholar.google.com, and I go there, and that takes me to Google Scholar. Now I can paste in what I said, okay, daycare female labor force participation. You know, you can try different things here. The search tool is kind of an art. And so you have to throw in different things here. You might try childcare, female labor force participation, or you might try childcare and work. Try a few different ones, you know, to see what you come up with, you know, each time doing the search. But that's how you do the search here. So let's look at what Google Scholar shows us. Okay, it lists any type of publication, academic publication that relates these words, child care, female work. The first thing I'd like us to do is focus on more on recent types of things. So over here, it's looking at any time, you know. So we have a 1992, a 74 article. Let's look at one more recent ones, just from 2010. Okay, and we start to get a sense of what people are studying in this area. Here's one, labor supply and childcare choices in a rationed childcare market. Okay, that sounds kind of interesting. Women in production, a critical analysis of sociological theories. Okay, maybe for a different type of paper. Maybe we're not finding what we want. We want to look at specifically participation. So let's go back to labor participation. Okay, I typed that in, and so maybe we're getting more what we're looking for. Female labor supply, why is the U.S. falling behind? That looks interesting, and then it has something on childcare. So if we want to look at one of these articles, we can click on it, but first I would encourage you to click on all versions, okay? All versions is going to give you every version of this paper that's found on the web, okay? Now some of these versions you click on, and you might not be able to get to it. So I click on this one, it costs $5. I don't want to do that. So I go back here. Anything with a PDF is going to be free. Okay, this PDF is at IZA.org. IZA is an international labor organization. So why would I pay $5 when I can get it for free? So I click on this one. Here we go. While we're waiting, the point of this lab is to find several papers and kind of condense them, kind of integrate them into something that's something to talk about all together. But you can read the abstract right here. You can read maybe the intro, some of the facts, you know, whatever. You read the paper to get a sense of what it's talking about. Now, if you decide that you like this paper and you want to use it in the lab, you go to cite here, okay? And this brings up the citation for the paper. I wanted you to use APA, so double click that and you can copy it. Let's Control C, copy, okay? And now you go back here to your lab and you've already started your deliverable or whatever. Let's get that open, my write-up template. You know, I ask you to, you know, type up your paragraph and stuff, and at the end, you're going to have a reference section. Okay, so you'll have your references. Here, let's go ahead and paste my reference. Okay, you'll want to fix the font and everything, but let's make a reference section for this. References. Okay, and now I have my references in here. I'm going to want to change that to, you know, make it look professional again, you know, the standard type stuff using the same font. But Google Scholar allowed me to find a lot of articles, cite the one that I use, things like that. So that's good, okay? Makes it a powerful tool. You go back, and if you liked this report, you can click on others that are related to it. You can click on articles that stemmed from this, that cite it elsewhere. Okay, so I clicked on that. So the first article was, why is the U.S. falling behind? I click on, you know, which articles cited that one. And here's, you know, things on gender, drivers of female labor force participation. This is leading me, the first article, finding one good article is leading me to others. So I can look at this one, maybe I like it. If I do like it, I'll go ahead and cite that. Okay, bring it over here. Oops, paste it, you know, paste in match formatting.
No.
It's not giving me what I want. Let's paste it special. Paste special, unformatted text, and there we go. Okay, I already have two articles. Okay, so this is how, if you find one good article, you can find others fairly quickly. So that's just an intro to Google Scholar. Recent articles, cite them, go to all versions to get the free version, and that's it. Good luck.